Welcome to week one of HORT 485 Advanced Permaculture Design Practicum. I'm Andrew Millison, I'm your instructor, and I'm sitting here in my garden here on a late summer's day in Corvallis, Oregon, and I'm really excited to get going on this class with you guys. I put a lot of energy into really making it something that I could be proud of. So, you know, as with most things that in the permaculture world, we're really starting with this wide perspective, right? We're really going from macro to micro, okay? And so that's how I do a design. That's how I analyze a site when I'm doing my work. And that's how this whole class is really formulated. So, you know, one of the first things that you are going to be doing for this class is a site selection, right? Figuring out which site you want, and we have four tracks. I'm gonna go through this with you in the presentation. We have four different perspectives, four different types of sites that you're gonna be working on. And so, you know, thinking about what it is in your work, what kind of a site, what kind of a specialization you wanna have in your permaculture work, that hopefully can really fuel your site selection and, you know, figure out what type of site and what scale of site you want to have the most practice with, right? And so that's really the perspective that you want to be having right now in the beginning of the class. I'm also going to give you a presentation on future scenarios, right? It's some of the work of David Holmgren, and it's really trying to get you thinking in this more wide philosophical lens of, you know, what are you designing for? Right? What is your projection of what's going to happen in the future, and what kind of program do you want based on your future projections for your design site as well? Got some assignments here. Once you select your site, you're going to do a watershed map. Right? We're starting like an eagle up in the sky, looking down at the greater landscape to figure out what are the patterns in the land. What's the watershed? Where's the natural boundaries, nature's property lines of your site? We're looking at soil maps as well, right? And looking at how soils have been distributed on your site. And you're also gonna do some readings in the designer's manual, right? The discussion board is going to involve a question about windbreaks for your particular climate. So really encourage you guys to interact with each other on that discussion board, and that's also a way that you're showing that you've done the readings that are signed. So I'm really looking forward to this, and I'll give you a little talk every week. I am going to be wearing the same shirt, you know, because I just pretty much never take this shirt off, so you'll see that every week I'll have the same shirt. In fact, every week my garden is going to be in the same state of development here, so it's really an amazing, magical place I've got, that it's always late summer here in my yard, as you'll see throughout this class. So, all right, well, let's get going, and I will talk to you soon. Take care.